Well, if you like ignore the orientalism of the of this placard with this figure with the turban, and I bet that the artist that made this plaque looked at an old photo of the city, and this is why this is actually gives a good description of what Jaffa was. It was a city, a dense city, full with buildings, with the fort on top, and the surrounding of the city. You can see the camels going by the sea on the shore, and you can see the backbone of the city, which are gardens and green areas. So actually, if you look past the orientalism of this image, it's a good image. My name is Dan Marcus. I'm an architect. I sometimes give tours here in Jaffa, talking about the old city. I had the great privilege studying with Professor Amnon Bar Or at the university and working with him at his atelier in Tel Aviv, almost exclusively on projects of restoration and conservation. We did quite a bit of a study about Old Jaffa, mapping the entire area that was once between the inside the city walls. Jaffa was once, in the 19th century, a really vibrant city, really dense urban fabric. It was actually the center of the Tel Aviv Metropolitan before Tel Aviv even existed. And through the years of destruction since 1936, when the British Mandate, when the British troops started demolishing parts of Jaffa, and through the war of 1948 and later in the 1950s and 1960s, actually the whole area which we are in right now, that was the old city, the old 19th century city of Jaffa, is almost entirely ruined. This situation where the core of the metropolitan area of the old city is ruined is virtually a strange park and not a Kasbah, not a dense urban area. We are now at Old Jaffa, at the area of, that was almost entirely ruined in 1948 by the Etzel, in the 1948 war during the occupation of Jaffa. Interestingly enough, this area remained ruined for about 10 years, and then in 1957, as this marble plaque tells us, the city of Tel Aviv started making a park out of this area. But this park is ripe with ruins. You can see that some of the stones here are landscaping stones brought especially in order to make stairs and terraces, in order to create areas for gardens. But most of the stones here are actually ruins of building, which were actually Palestinian houses and homes just 80 years ago. And if you just inspect the placing of this plaque, actually inside a room, this was somebody's bedroom. This ark survived all the demolition that took place here in 1948. And this plaque is kind of ignores it. For the people who put this plaque here, who put this garden here, these houses and these ruins are kind of a scenery, an image. And the people who put this plaque here couldn't really understand and see that this is an interior of a house. We can't always see the suffering of someone who is other than us. This way, in many respects, many Israelis can't really recognize in the stones around them houses and normal life of Palestinians. So to take somebody's house and then put it in a context of archaeology, putting in a context of just a scenery for a nice walk in the park, I think it's actually a crime. And I think the placement of this plaque really demonstrates it well.